What's up, guys? Back with another educational video, and this week we are talking about exercise. Does it help you burn body fat? Now, this might seem like a little bit of a weird topic, but this is in response to a recent study that came out examining the relationship between total daily energy expenditure and basal metabolic rate. So for a long time in the literature, we had this idea that if you, on average, burn 2,000 calories a day, if you exercise and say burned 300 calories from exercise, then you would burn a total of 2,300 calories per day. In fact, some people took it further and they said, well, you actually, like with HIIT or resistance training, you're gonna get an afterburn effect. So meaning not only is your calorie burn gonna be from the exercise itself, but then you're gonna have more energy expenditure from your basal metabolic rate. That's kind of like the performance model. And then the additive model is, okay, you burn 2,000 calories a day, do 300 calories of exercise, you burn 2,300 calories. But our understanding of total daily energy expenditure now appears to be quite different. Remember that total daily energy expenditure refers to the entire amount of energy that you expend during the day, whereas your basal metabolic rate is the amount of energy you expend basically just to keep the lights on. Just run normal physiological processes like digestion, absorption, your organs, your heart, your brain, all that sort of stuff. So when they looked at this group, it was a large data set of about 1,700 people. What they found was that as people got more active, they actually had a decrease in their BMR proportionately. On average, the compensation was, I believe, around 28%, meaning that if you added in 100 calories of exercise, your BMR would actually decrease by about 28 calories. This is association data, essentially. So it is possible that, okay, well, maybe people who just do tend to be more active genetically, because there does seem to be a genetic component to people who are spontaneously active, maybe they just have lower BMRs proportionately, and it's more of a genetic thing. But an analysis the researchers did tended to show that that's not necessarily the case, that it seems to be a within individuals effect. Meaning, if I add more exercise, it's likely my BMR will decrease slightly. A lot of people would ask, well, why would the body do this? Well, a big reason would be from a survival perspective. If you had to expend a lot of energy during the day on physical activity, in order to preserve and survive, because famine was a real thing 10,000 years ago, even though it's not now in America, you would want to expend the smallest amount of energy possible. So from that perspective, it makes sense that your body would try to become much more efficient in terms of your BMR and not waste so many calories. Now, there is another component to this, and that is perhaps people who do more activity just end up eating more. They become more hungry, those sorts of things. But there's actually some data that suggests that exercise actually improves your response to satiety signals, that you become more sensitive to satiety signals if you exercise. And you can see that in the fat loss research. People who lose weight and keep it off tend to do more exercise than those who don't. What I think the most interesting aspect of this study was they looked at kind of lean and average versus obese people by kind of plotting this data versus BMI. And they found something really interesting. And that was lean people only compensate about 10 to 20%. Obese people tend to compensate almost 50%. So that is, on average, if someone's obese and adds, say, 200 calories of exercise per day or of activity per day, their BMR may compensate by a reduction of 100 calories per day. So that's pretty significant, and it may explain why some people are more prone to obesity than other people. As an anecdote, everyone has that friend who, man, they can eat whatever they want and they just seem to not get fat. It's likely that they have compensatory mechanisms in the positive direction. We saw this in a study by Liebel et al. Way back in 1995. They overfed a group of people by 1,000 calories per day above their total daily energy expenditure that they assessed when they came in the lab. And they found that one person in that study actually didn't even put on any weight. They just became spontaneously much more active from eating more. Well, if that's true, the reverse could also be true, and that people who are more obese prone tend to just compensate more when they add exercise. So what is the take home for you guys? What does all this stuff mean? It doesn't mean that exercise is useless. Again, you are getting a net positive effect on total daily energy expenditure, even though there is some compensation for that. What it tends to suggest is that don't think that you can just burn 300 calories or whatever it is, and that you can just eat that amount of calories back. You can't. And that's one of the things about some of these tracking apps that I don't like, and one of the big reasons why on Carbon Diet Coach, our nutrition coaching app, we don't encourage for people to eat back the calories they burn from exercise. One, because calorie burn trackers are notoriously inaccurate, and two, because of these very compensatory mechanisms we're talking about. What else does it mean? I think one possible contributor to this could be NEAT, so non-exercise activity thermogenesis, that as people do more purposeful exercise, they become less spontaneously active. And spontaneous activity is way different than purposeful activity. So I know that during a contest prep years ago, I would have enough, I would go into the gym, I would train hard for 2 hours, I would do, you know, 30, 60 minutes of cardio, and then I would literally just lay down or sit down the entirety of the rest of the day. So I was compensating and didn't even realize it because I was doing so much activity, I didn't have energy just to spontaneously get up and move around. In fact, I can very clearly remember having a TV show on TV that I hated, but I didn't change the channel because the remote was 10 feet away from me and I did not want to get up and have to go get it. So I think that NEAT could be part of it. So one of the things I like to do with people, especially during fat loss phases, is track their steps. While these watches aren't very accurate for tracking calories burned, they are pretty accurate for tracking steps. And so if you know that on average, you're getting, say, 8,000, you can always make it a priority that if you're adding in exercise or you're doing exercise or you're going into a calorie deficit, that you just say, okay, that's my average before this calorie deficit or before I add this exercise. I need to make sure that I still hit that 8,000 steps today, even though I'm adding this exercise, even though I'm adding resistance training or whatever else it may be. And I think that might be a way, at least in part, to help prevent some of these compensatory mechanisms. So at the end of the day, the biggest takeaway is just realize that exercise is still useful and, by the way, has a lot of benefits outside of the weight loss it might induce, but just exercising for most people is not going to produce a linear weight loss effect. This may also be why some people say things like, well, I ate in a calorie deficit and I didn't lose weight because, you know, I was eating 1800 calories and I was burning 1000 calories per day in exercise. Well, you actually probably weren't. So again, exercise is not useless, still very, very useful, but be aware of these compensatory mechanisms and how they might impact your progress. All right, guys, make sure to like and subscribe to the channel. Also, check out our educational ebooks like Fat Loss Forever, where I talk about some of these subjects in detail, and download and subscribe to our nutrition coaching app, Carbon Diet Coach, clicking the links in the description. All right, guys, hope you enjoyed it, and I will catch you next week.